had some amazing artists today on stage. I've seen some of them. And thankfully, her talk just helped me motivate more while talking. Yeah, even I shiver. Okay. So I'm going to ask a very silly question that basically is connected to this talk. How many of you people actually love art? Can you raise hands? Oh, a lot of them. Okay. How many of you actually have a passion for art? You want to pursue it as career? Okay, very few. And how many of you are actually on the right track of pursuing that as a career? Yeah, I see some, only two of them. I guess I'm at the right place. So for all those people who are still wandering, or for people who have given up their passion to get into a well-paying job, let me reignite that thought by saying you have a choice to do both. You have a choice to follow your dream at the well. At the same time, you have a choice to have your job. And this is what I call multitasking. So multitasking for me is basically when a person is able to play two different roles at the same time. And it has to be done simultaneously and smoothly. It can be a passion and a passion. It can be a job and a passion, or two different jobs. So let's take a look at our careers. A career has two components associated to it. Your career choices, which are basically more financially secured, that you're going to take or would have already taken till now. And your career dreams that are more artistic. So basically, when these two components are there, we will find that practically most of us, almost every one of us would have their career choices different from their career dreams. And why is that? Well, financial stability. We all want financial stability. And that is fine. I would say that is totally okay. Who doesn't want financial stability? But what not is okay is slowly drifting away from your passion. The sadness of losing your true calling is very painful. There was a recent survey conducted in UK by Pittman's Training, and they came up with a very alarming figures. They told us that 84% of the people, 84% of the youth did not know how to convert their passion into their career. I mean, how alarming is that? Then they were asked another question. They were asked, if you had to choose one particular field where you want to excel as a career, which one it would be? And a staggering 49% people said they wanted to get into music. 25% people said that they were curious about technology. They wanted to have their own startup. Then we had 35% people saying that they wanted to get into fashion designing. And 21% people said that they wanted to get into sports. But none of them said that they wanted to be a desk job. They wanted to have a desk job, an admin job. Let me introduce to you some of the most famous personality when it comes to multitasking. Jack Gleason, you would have probably heard of this guy, I guess. A lot of you. Game of Thrones fans. And at one point, he was the most hated guy on this planet. We have to agree. That's how good he acts. But do you know one thing? He multitasks his acting along with his studies. And when he died in season 4, he went back to his hometown to pursue his degree. Mayim Malik, probably aware of her, right? Obviously, Amy from Big Bang Theory. Okay, that's not her full name. Her full name is Dr. Mayim Malik. You know what she does? She's actually a neuroscientist. The only person who gives justice to that role in Big Bang Theory. How amazing is that? And it's not an easy field to be in. Frankie Muniz, if you're a 90s kid, you probably know this. He's the baby face from Malcolm in the Middle. And acting is probably his first choice, but you know what his second choice is? It's very weird. Race car driving. He actually owns race cars. Then we have Lucy Liu. I don't think you guys need her introduction at all. She's the dazzling diva from Kill Bill, Charlie's Angels. And apart from acting, she does a lot of painting. And most of her paintings, she donates it to charity. How nice is that? So I've read somewhere, and I put it in my talk just now, that mostly people tend to get convinced when you tell them your own life experiences. So I'm going to tell you how I achieved multitasking and what are the different roles I do as a multitasker. So I worked as a software consultant in one of the big four audit companies. I play for three different bands as a songwriter and a musician. Own game development and design company called Kraken Studios, and I take a lot of videography and photography assignments from my parents. So I'm going to get you back to 2010 when I first started out my corporate career. And 2 years before that, I had just got into music. And the journey to learn music along with my engineering studies was very difficult. And it was only going to get worse when I came to know that I was going to get into corporate world. So I had a choice to make. Either I can follow my passion or I can have my job. But the figures on the offer letter were too tempting. So what did I do? I thought to myself, is it possible for me to actually carry on doing both? Will it help me? How will I do that? There were people I have seen that were able to do both, but they were very few and very rare, and none of them were actually near me to tell me how it is to be done. So I took a risk. I said, let's just give it a try. If it does not work out, I'm going to quit my job and get into passion altogether. I got into the new city for my job, applied for a couple of bands, got into one, and that is the time where my experiment to multitask my job and my passion started to begin. The next 6 points that I'm going to discuss is basically my 8 years of experience that I've formulated and came up these points with. And the first and the foremost point that I'm going to start off with is basically the old school version, we say practice, and I call it perseverance. So perseverance is basically constantly grinding at one thing which you love doing. And that one thing can be anything. It can be music, it can be art, it can be dancing, let it be anything. But you have to make sure out of your daily life, you're giving some time for your passion. Now, how did I do it? So we usually lack time when it comes to a corporate job. But I made sure no matter what happens, I have to give that 1 hour from my daily life to my passion. It can be any time of the day, but I have to make sure no matter what happens, I have to give 7 hours per week. Let's take it more extreme, 30 hours per month. Even more, 90 hours, 3 months, that's close to 100, I'm giving for my guitaring. Those amount of hours are almost equal to getting into a beginner level guitarist, and you'd probably never even knew that you were going to get there by doing just basically perseverance. Now, when I say perseverance and I talk about the timelines like 3 months and everything, there's going to be one thing that's going to bother you, and that's going to be time management. And this is very important, because when you try to follow your job and your passion at the same time is a very crucial thing. You have seen most of the people, they give you this excuse, hey, why are you not doing this? Why are you not following your passion? They'll probably tell you, you know what, I don't have time. And how do we tackle this? So basically, most of us, when we go for our job, probably you guys will probably in future, you'll be working in shift. You'll probably have a morning shift or an evening shift or a night shift. But there will be some amount of time in your daily life where you could give to your passion. So if you're going for your job very early in the morning, make sure you give your 1 hour in the evening. If you're leaving late for work, make sure you give your 1 hour in the morning. And it does not need to be hour, like at one particular instance of time. You can divide that hour as half an hour in the morning, half an hour in the evening. But make sure whatever happens, that 1 hour has to come. Now let's face it practically. Sometimes I may miss that 1 hour because there's going to be a lot of corporate workload, which even I had. But I made sure that at the end of the week, I compensate for that hour. Those 2 hours I missed for 2 days, that's when I'm going to compensate in the weekend. Because after office hours and weekends is where the magic happens. You need to know which all social gatherings require your attention, which do not, which are mandatory, which are not. Steal those hours from those social gatherings and giving it to a passion. Consistency and time management will be there, but it's going to get you somewhere along the way. And you're going to talk about this 3 months timeline, I bet most of you will probably give up in the 2 weeks. Why? Because there's one thing that's going to get a better of us, and it's called patience. This is a weird word, I would say, motivating your patience. I came up with this. Let me get you back to one of my time when I had to start coding games. How many of you love actually Dota 2? Have you played Dota 2? League of Legends? So yeah, when I started my game coding passion, I was so excited. I was like, oh my God, I hit a jackpot. Now, not only I can play games, I can create my own. I was like, okay, the next game I'm going to create is going to be at competition for Dota 2. I'm going to make another League of Legends, that, you know, competition to Valve. But you know what happened? I was wrong. My goals were impractical. Within the span of 2 months that I spent extensively coding my game out, I realized at the end of the day, it is going nowhere. You know why? Because my goals were not practical. I gave up that dream of mine and I just moved on. But 4 months down the line, I made sure I came back to my game development and started recoding things. But this time, learning from my previous mistake, I just picked up a very small mini game. 3 years to make the character, 3 days to make the character, 2 days just to, you know, make it move here and there, and another 2 days to make it interact with the environment. So what did I do over here? I made sure my goals were very small. They were within timelines, and at the same time, they were practical. I was able to do them. And when I start getting these small goals, I realized I was feeling happy I was feeling motivated. And when you feel happy and motivated, you're never going to look at the timeline. And since the mode of your goal achieving is going to be in chunks, you're always going to feel like motivated and happy. And that's what I say, motivating your patience. Your patience will never come into picture when you see that you're improving, because that's what's going to give you happiness. My next point is going to be independence. So how would you define independence? Independence for me is something where you actually get to do your task without interference of anyone else. I mean, most of you would probably hear this from a lot of people. They would say, hey, why are you not following your dream of achieving your guitaring or your art? We usually wait for somebody to tell us that, you know what, this is how it is done, or you know what, this is how it is done. Somebody who can tutor us or guide us. My point is, we are living in 21st century. There's a whole data out there that's going to give you tutorials on whatever you want to follow. Name it art, name it anything else. You will have that data there on the internet. Now let's talk statistically. Most of us, we are from metropolitan cities. And statistically speaking, an average person, an average individual in a metro city spends around 1 hour just on public transport. You know why? 20 minutes of road these days takes us as an hour because of the traffic and everything. You have a universe in your hand. You have your phone. Download those tutorials. Watch them when you're on the go. You may not be able to play your guitar in the bus or in the cab, but you would definitely be able to learn the basics or all the technical aspects of guitar on the video. And go home and try it out. Once you see that, okay, this is how the C chord is played, I'll just go home and try it out. That's how you have to do your independence. You have to make sure you're not dependent on anyone. Get those tutorials downloaded on your phone and start doing these things. So all the 4 points that I've talked till now are more or less related to you. But there's one point that is more dependent on the environment that you're going to work in. That's called adaptability. So as an artist, we have to work in teams. We can never work alone until we reach that particular level where we say that I'm going to go solo. So taking into consideration that I was in a band, I had to actually deal with a lot of different people. There were people who wanted me to be kicked out, or there were people I wanted to kick out. But the point is, you have to make sure that whatever the thing is happening, whatever the role people are playing in the band, you should not quit your passion. Things will change. The way you play your music, the number of people you deal with, or the way you deal with those people, that might change. That is going to happen, because there's going to be a personality clashes when you talk about teams. But the bottom line here is, make sure you are not quitting your passion. I've seen a lot of people, when they kicked out of their band or their production houses, they just leave it all together and say, this is not meant for me. Never let that feeling come into you. Make sure you're doing that. Never quitting your passion. Don't stop. My last point is, I think a lot of you people would have heard about it. It's called solitude. What is solitude? Solitude is that sweet time that you need to come up with the best in you. So there was a research in University of Los Angeles that told us that the human brain is able to perform at its maximum when it is enclosed, or when you start it in a silent environment. When you sit down and have in a silent environment, it's going to perform the maximum. So that's what solitude comes into picture. I mean, how are you going to make that perfect riff for your next song or that next tech startup if you're not going to have your own sweet time? Make sure that you get your own sweet time. Learn to embrace your solitude. It is very important. For me, as a multitasker, close down your door, get into your room, and start doing the things that you always wanted to do. Get your laptop out, start drawing, start playing your guitar. But make sure you have solitude in your daily schedule. My point at the conclusion would be, try these 6 points out, which I have told you just now, for a span of 3 months. It might work for you, it might not. My model has its own flaws. But when you start earning 80% of your job from your passion, that's the time you should know that you have to quit your job and get into your passion completely. But at the same time, you can juggle between both the things if you feel you're okay with it, you're happy, and you're satisfied. That's what I am doing, and I'm happy with it. I'm going to conclude this talk by saying a quote from Steve Jobs, and it says, "Stay hungry, stay foolish." Thank you.